You're watching Life and Health News. Up next, our fifth period broadcast.
To receive euthanasia. This was passed for children who are close to death, experiencing constant and unbearable suffering. It's the first country to allow, to lift all age restrictions off euthanasia.
I think that it was a terrible idea on the Belgian Parliament's part to pass this type of bill. I mean, you can just imagine the horrible repercussions. I mean, even though it was intended only for children who it's a merciful death, you can imagine that children in, for example, families that can't afford medical treatment will choose to kill themselves in order to lift an economic burden on their families. How can this be good?
I mean, I beg to differ. I think you have to think about this from an ill child's perspective. You know, you have to say, okay, well, am I going to live my life constantly suffering in pain for a lost cause, or am I going to try to, you know, at least ease my suffering, ease others' suffering? You know, I wouldn't want to live in constant pain. I would rather just alleviate myself from that.
Well, what if they euthanized a child and it turned out there was a cure a couple years later, but because they chose to euthanize that child, the child cannot be, it's dead now.
Mm. I mean, a couple years is a long time, you have to understand. I mean, how many is a couple years? Is it a year, 2 years? Is it 15 years?
Anton has a nice story.
So there's a new research that says flu vaccines could be a complete quackery and that they are based on faulty research and only create antibodies in patients that are already healthy or don't need the vaccine in the first place. So I think that it's, I think the research doesn't look good for flu vaccines. I think it's just a lot of big corporations trying to make money off of vaccines.
I think this research sounds ridiculous. I mean, there's a reason why flu vaccines have existed for so long. Just because a little bit of new research supposedly defies, you know, contradicts that, doesn't mean that flu vaccines have absolutely no merit whatsoever.
This new research digs into the research that actually justifies flu vaccine and exposes the lack that there is. So I think that's what this study is really all about, is exposing the lack of research behind flu vaccines.
If flu vaccines didn't work, then why do people get flu vaccines?
Because companies making these vaccines are making millions and billions of dollars off selling them to most of the population of the United States and telling them that if they don't get them, then they'll get sick.
I mean, I personally, I'd like to just, is this a study done by one person? Is this one study, or is this multiple groups researching one thing? Or were they specifically looking for this? I mean, it's just, I think that this sounds kind of like a biased
It's an article that was written by people that actually looked into the research behind flu vaccines and exposed what nobody else wanted them to know. So
we'll keep you updated on this.
Now, the weather.
It is 91,000 damn degrees.
This has been the weather on Life and Health News.
And, we have field operatives going out and investigating news.
Dr. Singh, a patient safety expert, found that at least 5% of cases doctors misdiagnose their patients the first time. 12 million Americans are affected each year. 6 million of those mistakes could actually cause serious harm. Misdiagnoses are often due to inadequate resources or limited time with patients. Now we're going to cut to our reporter in the field who will be interviewing people at a local high school.
This is Allison Smith, and I will be interviewing Mr. George. So, has a doctor ever misdiagnosed you?
Not that I'm aware of.
Well, did you know that 1 in 20 doctors misdiagnose their patients?
I did not know that.
Do you have a comment about that? Opinion?
I don't know. I like my odds. What?
Okay, back to you.
Thanks, Allison. Moving on to our next story. Federal health authorities reported a 43% drop in the obesity rate among children 2 to 5 years old during the past decade. This is the first decline in the obesity rate in a long time, and it's some promising news for a tough epidemic.
We're going to go to our field operative, Brad, who's going to report on interview individuals at a local high school about this topic.
Hey guys, I'm here with Bob.
Clark,
what do you think about obesity?
I think obesity is probably good. It's better than the other. I mean, not enough is better than too much. But I understand from you, Brad, that obesity is going down. What's causing that? Is that a dilemma?
Let's go.
I'm not actually sure. I know that it's just going down in children right now. Did you know that it's going down?
I didn't know that. Is it the new school lunch program?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
I think that, because my understanding is that under the new school lunch program, the kids are throwing all the food away rather than eating it.
Yeah.
Which, of course, would contribute to the demise of obesity.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
Yeah. Okay,
go ahead.
Hey, guys. I'm here with Senior Shaw. Senior Shaw, what do you think about childhood obesity?
I think it's an epidemic in this country. Fortunately, steps have been taken to curtail childhood obesity, but I believe there's still an epidemic.
Hey, Senior Sharp, did you know that childhood obesity is going down right now in America?
I do know that it's going down, but I must say that right now I am craving a double-double with animal fries.
That's great. All right, back to you guys.
Okay.
Thanks, Brad. In the United States and around the world, AIDS has created a problem for millions of people. AIDS is often transmitted through unprotected sex and sharing of needles. But there is a new drug called Truvada that is preventative towards the HIV virus. And federal health officials in May recommended that hundreds of thousands of Americans at most risk for AIDS take the daily pill that has been shown to drastically prevent the infection of the HIV virus. We're going to Allison Smith, our field operative, who's going to investigate and interview individuals about this news.
Thank you. Hi, I'm here with Olivia Daniels. Olivia, do you think AIDS is a big problem in the world today?
I think it's a big problem, especially for countries that don't have access to help in clinics like we do in America. I think the problem has definitely been resolved more than it was like in the 80s, since we have medications that can help aid people with it, but people in countries like Africa who don't have that kind of thing available, it is still an enormous problem and it takes a lot of lives.
Ian, how do you feel about the new AIDS pill?
Go for it.
Thanks, Allison.
Up next, we will be bringing you a special broadcast on the top 10 most controversial commercials of this year. First up, number 10.
Iris Wong?
Yeah.
I'm sorry to say this, but your test results came back and you have brain cancer. Yes, I'm so sorry. However, I will be prescribing cannabis to you, so if you head over to the pharmaceutical company, they can provide you with that. And hopefully it will help with the cure. So, Iris, after 2 months of treatment, I am pleased to say that your cancer is gone. How incredible. You're cured. Congratulations.
Cannabis cures cancer. Buy yours today.
Many studies show that cannabis, or marijuana, an illicit drug, can cure many forms of cancer. This is amazing considering that marijuana is a Schedule 1 drug and has no, or is considered to have no medical benefits. I believe it should be legalized, or at least legalized for medical benefits.
Every year, thousands of kids die due to illness and disease. But with the hard work of healthcare workers and your kind donations, you can help bring peace and health to the world. Just recently, India was certified polio-free. What can you do for your country? Donate.
Truly is phenomenal. The last case reported was in January of 2011, and UNICEF had sent 2.3 million vaccine administrators to reach the most vulnerable of people. And it truly is incredible that a country could be rid of the disease, especially in a place like India where it was so common.
I dropped out of high school and now I'm a bus driver.
I went to Oklahoma State and now I'm a secretary.
I went to Yale Business School. I'm now a top executive and I genuinely live a happier life.
Study hard, get into an amazing college, equals happiness. Visit us at Don't Drop Out to find good study tips.
Contrary to this advertising, a recent poll found that graduates from prestigious colleges don't evaluate their own success and happiness in life to be higher than those of graduates from average colleges. The conclusion that prestigious colleges don't affect later happiness in life is interesting, but I feel that this survey was flawed because people who go to prestigious colleges tend to be more ambitious in life and thus have higher stress jobs, which may reduce their happiness in life. Do you think it's impossible to lose weight? Well, you haven't tried the paleo diet yet. Paleo diet is a brilliant diet, clinically, scientifically proven to make you lose weight and live a happier, healthier life.
I feel the best I've felt in 20 years. I mean, I've lost a ton of weight. I feel healthy all the time. It just worked really well.
All you do is don't eat carbs. It's that simple. You can gorge on all the fat and meat and fat that you want. Get your copy of The Paleo Diet at your local bookstore and start living a happier life today.
Even though paleo diets are popular, studies have found that they are not as healthy as they are promoted to be, and have adverse health cures, including shortening lifespan. Personally, I think it's unhealthy.
Mommy, I don't feel good.
Oh, Zach, you have fever?
Yeah.
Tiredness?
Mm-hmm.
The chills?
Yeah.
Sudden onset?
Yep.
We're taking you to get a shot.
No, I don't like shots.
Does your child ever complain about getting a shot? They imagine the long, thick needle going under their skin. Well, here at Kaiser, we've decided to start administering a flu patch instead of the needle, which is more effective and less pain for your kids. So what are you doing? Take them over to Kaiser. Kaiser Permanente. Thrive.
Although it's not certain that Kaiser is administering this flu patch, it is actually a great idea. I mean, I personally think it's great, you know. It's pain-free, kids love it. I personally hate shots as a kid, so I mean, I think this would definitely promote the general health.
Does your kids suck at baseball? We'll send them to our camp.
For only $10,000, we'll make him an all-star.
Look at this kid.
He is using a diamond-plated bat provided by our staff. He will be the best baseball player of all time.
Guaranteed.
Guaranteed for only $10,000.
It's a home run.
A sports psychologist found the more parents spend on their kids' sports career, the more likely they are to exert pressure on their kids, and that they will feel pressure. I think parents have always been encouraged to support their kids, but sometimes they can cross the line between encouraging and pushing.
How are you doing?
Not so good, Doc. How's that cough? Not so good, Doc. Oh well. How are you, doctor?
I'm good, thank you. So how are your, do you have any joint pain?
A little bit. I'm doing better, though.
Anything that stands out?
No.
All right. Well, I mean, if you need anything, you can either buzz in a nurse or have them page me. You know, I'm available whenever you need me. I'll check back in with you tomorrow.
Thanks, doc. You're the best.
Shows that when doctors are given patient interaction training, the patients show more positive results. Personally, I think that all doctors should receive this training so that patients have better overall results.
A message from the Coca-Cola Company.
Here at Coca-Cola, we prioritize your health, which is why we've recently removed brominated vegetable oil from our products. Now, you can enjoy Coca-Cola without any adverse health effects whatsoever.
Even though the Coke drink has taken out the chemical BVO, it is still very unhealthy for you.
Yeah.
I think it is wrong for them to be promoting this drink as a healthy drink while it's still very unhealthy.
Creativity, and even increasing lifespan. Winston Churchill, Napoleon, and Einstein all napped, and napping is actually natural in mammals. I personally think that napping should be socially acceptable because it is in like places like Japan where people have high rates of work productivity. I think we should do that too.
Lazy teenagers like the one you just saw are subject to junk food addiction, and they're crying out for help. Lost, friendless, and with nowhere to turn, they seek comfort in their taste buds. Call the number on your screen and join the OHCBFAL. For just $9,300 a month, $300 a day, we can help these poor children get off their fat, lazy asses and eat lettuce. Call or join online in the next 30 minutes, and you'll receive this welcome kit with a photo of a child suffering from junk food addiction right now who's been given a second chance to try broccoli, thanks to you. Right now, there's a child who needs you. Your call says eat some broccoli. Please call right now.
We have junk food engineered to addict you to chemical ingredients. Junk food these days is not designed to eat slowly or a few at a time, but rather vigorously eaten until the bag expires or until you reach the nearest convenience store.
Here at H&L, we provide coverage for what's most important to your life and health. Thank you and have a good night.